Oh, hey guys, Rome Guruji here. And today I'm going to be talking about the IQ3 once again. Why? Well, it's going to be available for 29,900 in the upcoming Flipkart sale. But before we get into the details, if you're new here, press that subscribe button and the bell icon for all the notifications. And let's get started. So guys, why did I decide to talk about the IQ3 once again? Well, it's available for much cheaper and a lot of people are commenting on my old videos about whether they should buy the IQ3 or not. So I decided to make this short video to tell you the important points about the IQ3 so that you are informed before you buy this phone and aren't like me who was uninformed and just genuinely impressed by the hardware when I bought this, right? So wait, let's first talk about the design, okay? So about the design is exceptionally good, okay? So it's a very, very nice design, right? The back is glossy. Yes, it's a fingerprint magnet, if you can see the fingerprints, right? But you see this reflective, beautiful design it has. That's really nice. That's really good, right? The front of the phone is really, really good looking, right? And that punch hole is one of the smallest in its category. So that's really good. But aside from the design, the biggest reason why people would be buying this phone is the Snapdragon 865 in this. Well, it's not just Snapdragon 865. It's the LPDDR5 RAM, the UFS 3.1 storage, and the 55-watt charging that makes this an amazing contender. But that's not it. It also has these air triggers called Monster Touch buttons. Yeah, this is so very cool. Then why is it so underrated? Now that is where the problems come and that is where you need to know. Well, the phone's hardware is exceptional. Even the camera is amazing. A lot of phones do not have a good wide angle. This one probably has the best wide angle camera I have seen in the industry, right? But the one place where it sucks, and forgive my English, is really bad, is the UI. Well, the UI is not exceptionally bad. It does not have outdated software. It just has really lackluster software. So it is basically the first iteration of a UI that is trying to move away from Vivo's FunTouch OS, and they are not doing a very, very good job at it. Yes, obviously you're going to get Android 11 beta faster, but you don't know where the stable version is. So that is something that has been happening. Moreover, the company is not that experienced when giving out updates for its own OS. So a lot of those updates suddenly make the phone a lot better or suddenly deteriorate the phone. So as far as the UI or the system of the phone goes, it's not that great. Now a lot of people are asking me, is it good for 3 years? Well, they've promised you two major Android updates. So you're going to get Android 11, you're going to get Android 12. So you do not need to worry about the Android updates, and they're going to continue giving you security updates for 3 years. So you do not need to worry about that either. Is it durable? Yes, it is durable. The screen is beautiful, scratch resistance. I love it, right? It has Scotch sensation on the front and Gorilla Glass on the back. So yes, the screen is great. It is a bit hefty, that I'll tell you. A lot of people have also asked me, is it hefty? Yes, it is a bit hefty. Network problems, now there aren't any network problems there. So you must remember, a lot of people have been asking me, no, the network problems have been fixed, but there is a new problem. It has this standby battery drain, which is really killing the battery efficiency here. So you might need to look into that. You might need to remember that. So that is something that needs to be fixed here. Otherwise, great, great. No battery drain otherwise, but standby, yes, there's a huge battery drain problem. Network has been fixed, so that's good. The screen has no problem anymore. There's no flickering fluctuation in the screen also. So that's really, really nice. So that has also been fixed. Durability is yes. Sound quality is decent, but if you use the audio jack. Oh, by the way, it has an audio jack. Do you know that? Yeah, it has an audio jack, and this jack has hi-fi DAC. So if you're going to use the audio, like you're going to listen to some really, really high quality songs using the hi-fi DAC, you're in for a surprise. This is a really, really good quality headphone jack, and the output is substantially amazing. You're going to enjoy playing games if you're connected to this port. Now, a lot of people do not know, this phone for some reason does not show the capability of running aptX or LDAC, all of those really hi-fi Bluetooth functions. I have no clue why, because it's supposed to have those. So it might be something with the software issue. Again, software issues are a lot, so that might be there. There's no custom ROM support, there's no bootloader unlocking here. So do remember that, no bootloader unlock there, right? Big problem if you want to continue using it after 3 years, you're not going to have any custom ROM development. It's going to be really sad, right? Very simple right there. Now, should you buy this? Well, at 29,900, the hardware is extremely awesome. It is super value for money. But that is if you're okay with the UI problems. If you're not okay with the UI problems, you're not essentially a gamer. Talking about being a gamer, this one has an amazing gaming performance. So do remember that with the Monster Touch button, gaming is a breeze. So this one does not lag at all in games, but the UI is laggy, right? So that's there. So if you are not essentially a gamer or you can't really deal with all the UI bugs, I would suggest you to look elsewhere. If you're one of a kind of a productivity person, I would suggest you look at the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Lite. So Note 10 Lite is actually pretty good as far as productivity goes, or you can look at Realme X3 Pro, Realme X3 Super Zoom, or you can look at Xiaomi's new offerings. They're great. Even I think Mi 10T is going to come at 35,000. So that's really cool. But then again, if you're looking for value for money hardware and you are really, really in a hope or are optimistic or really don't care about the UI, go for iQOO 3. I mean, hardware is awesome, right? The UI needs improvement. So if you're okay with that, go for iQOO 3. If you do like my video, if you do love the channel, support us by pressing that subscribe button, giving us a thumbs up. And that's all for this video, guys. I hope this helps you and I hope this makes you do an informed buy. If it does, leave a comment down below, right? Thank you, guys, and I'll see you again.